this tutorial was born when my 10-year-old son found my old Rubik's Cube in a drawer and asked me how to play. And I told him, you have to get 6 faces, each of a single color. So he started to try, and after a while he told me again, but how do you do it? How can you solve it? But I didn't remember anything about how to solve the Rubik's Cube, so embarrassed, I told him that it was not so easy and that I would have to study a bit. And I tried for hours. Then looking on the internet, I found dozens of tutorials, more or less complicated. Often I found explanations very complex and detailed, or on the contrary, simple but too rough. So I tried to make my own tutorial so that it was easy but at the same time sufficiently precise to be able to solve the cube in any case. Then I gave it to my son and he made a lot of progress. He almost arrived at the final solution, so I decided to share it on YouTube, and I hope it can help everyone, young and old people. So anyone can amaze his friends or his parents or maybe the boyfriend or girlfriend, always managing to solve the cube. Guaranteed success. So let's start the tutorial just with a bit of terminology, just to make sure we understand each other during the tutorial. So the cube is made by faces and of course has 6 faces, but each face has a name. This is the front face. This is the back face, which is opposite to the front. Then we have the top face, the bottom face, the right face, and the left face. Also, these little cubes have a name. This is the center cube. And then we have 4 corner cubes. And then we have 4 middle cubes, because they are in the middle of the side of the face. So center, corners, middle cubes. And the color of the face is determined by the color of the center cube, because this is the only cube that can't move away from its face. So this is the green face, this is the yellow, this is the red, and so on. And also we can consider the face and the cube made of layers. This is the bottom horizontal layer, this is the horizontal center layer, and this is the top horizontal layer. And then we have also the right vertical layer, then we have the center vertical layer, which is this one, and then the left vertical layer. So when we talk about layers, we talk about these 9 cubes horizontally or vertically arranged. The main idea is that in order to solve the cube, there are 5 basic steps that must be performed in the pre-established order. Sometimes, however, steps 4 and 5 are formed by 2 subfaces each, for a total of 7 steps in total. Each of these steps has its own sequence of moves that must be performed correctly before moving on to the next step. So, in order to create the white cross, which means to have white here, 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 and here, of course, we have to find the little cubes that are white in the middle of the side of the faces. So we are interested only in this, for example, this, and this cube. And so we have some different cases. For example, we have the white face in the bottom horizontal layer, like this, or like this. Or we have the white here in the center horizontal layer, or also we have the white here in the bottom face. And for each of these cases, we have some moves that we need in order to transfer these white squares here in these positions. So for example, this is one of the easiest cases, because you see you have white here and orange here, so you have to turn this bottom face to match orange with orange, and then this white has to be positioned here, and it's very easy because you have just to turn twice 180 degrees and you have positioned this white piece properly, because you have white here and orange here. Then for example, you have this white and green, which is in front of you, so you have to turn until you find the green, and then you have to transfer this white here up here. So here you use a sequence, right down the vertical center layer, then you go back towards left with your bottom layer, and then up again with the vertical center, and you position properly also this one. Then you have, for example, this case with white in the center horizontal layer, and here again you you can rotate this in order to have this white again in the lower layer. Then you do a rotation with blue in this way, and now again you are in the previous case, so you can rotate towards right, then down the vertical center, back with the bottom, again up with the center, vertical center, and you position also this one. Then you have again this one, which is the white red, you do exactly the same. So in this position with the white matching the front face, you go right, then you go down with the vertical center, and you go back with the bottom horizontal, and here you finished your white cross, which is also correct because it's red with the red, blue with blue, orange and green, and this is the cross. Then we have to position the four corners, the four white corners. We have already a white corner here, but this is not in the wrong position, because you see here you have green and here you have orange, but here we must have orange and here blue, so this is not in the correct place. We have white here, for example, which is orange and blue, white, orange and blue. So we can do simply like this. We consider this orange and we turn here to have this match, orange with orange. Then, always keeping white as a top face, you have this white in front of you, and then you have to consider that this is on the left side of the face, so you have to turn right instead of left, then go down with the orange face, then you turn on the back again, and you go up, and this is correctly positioned, and you repeat this process for all the others, all the other cubes. So orange green, for example, we go again orange here, we look at the cube with this white square in front of us, then this is on the right, then we turn on the left, then we go down with this right vertical layer, then we go back, and then we go back up, and this is right positioned. Then we have these two which are not in this bottom horizontal layer. This is in the top, this is in the face at the bottom. So in this case we have, for example, blue and red, so we turn the face towards this blue and red, and then we use this schema and we repeat the schema: down, left, up, right, again down, left, up, right, down, left, up, and we see that the cube is in the right position. Then we do exactly the same also for this one, because it's not in the bottom face, the white square is not in the bottom face, so in the bottom layer, so we do exactly the same: down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, and we can stop it here because we have completed the first phase and the first layer. If we turn the cube, we have the first horizontal layer, which is completed: red, green, orange and blue. Now we have to complete the second layer, which means this center horizontal layer. We have to put here three oranges, and here the blue, and here the reds, and here the greens. So we look for the cubes to put in these positions, and we look for these cubes in this top face, which is the yellow one, and the white face is the bottom one. We look in this face and we look in the middle positions, and we look for the cubes that that have not yellow in their squares. So for example, these two are not of interest for us, but this and this are useful. So for example, we start from the blue and red. Blue and red means we have to turn the blue here to match this center square, and then we have to place this blue and red cube here, because we have red and in here we have blue, so we have to turn to move this cube in this position towards left. So now we have a sequence to do exactly as it must be. So we have to right, up, left, down, left, forward, rotation, right, and here we are. So we have transferred this blue and red cube here. Then we have, for example, this green and red. Green and red, we turn the red with the red, and the green must go here again on the left, so we have right, up, left, down, left again, forward, right and backward. And here we placed the red and green. And we proceed with the other. So for example, here we have orange and green. We put the orange here, and then we have to put the green here. This time it's towards the right side, so we have to turn left, up, right, down, right, backward, the front, left, the top, and forward, the front. And here we have the orange and green. And then we look here for the blue, orange. Blue, orange is matched here, and then has to go again on the right side. So we move on the left, left, up, right, down, right again, backward, left, and forth. And here we have completed the two layers step. Sometimes happens that the cubes you need are already in the horizontal center layer, so they are positioned in the wrong position, or maybe they are not well oriented. But in this case, you have simply to apply always the same moves we saw before. For example, if you have the cube which is in the wrong position but is already in the center horizontal layer and stays on your left, you can apply this schema in order to move it up to the top layer. The same if you have the cube which is on the right side of the face or the front face, you can apply this schema in order to move again it on the top layer. And when you have the cube on the top layer, then you are ready to apply the sequence of moves we saw before. Now we have the new step, which is to create another cross. This time is the yellow cross on the opposite face of the white one. So to create the yellow cross here, this time we have to use a sequence of moves that we have to perform. And for example, this is a cube, which is also correct. So we can decide to start from here. And we have to, like this, we have to rotate here up, right, then clockwise the back, left, counterclockwise the back, and down. And here we don't have a cross, again, still we don't have a cross. So we have to repeat the process. But we can put this green matching this face. So again, up, right, clockwise, left, counterclockwise, and down. And we don't have the cross. So we repeat again, keeping the yellow squares on the right, up, right, clockwise, left, counterclockwise, and down. And we don't have again the cross, but we repeat the process again, up, right, clockwise, left, counterclockwise, and down. And we are almost done, up, right, clockwise, left, counterclockwise, and down. We are very, very close to the cross, up, right, clockwise, left, counterclockwise, and down. We rotate to have the right, to have the yellow squares on the right, and up, right, clockwise, left, counterclockwise, and down. Oh, and here we have our cross. And we don't care about these two corners. And we have a look to this color. This is in the right position because it is red and red. This is not in the right position. This is wrong and this is wrong. So this is the first of the two phases of this step. Then we have to correct this these three colors which are not correct. So this is another sequence that you have to perform, which is always up, left, down, left, up, left, left, down. So in this case, you see, this is correct, this is correct, this is correct, and this is correct. And we finished our yellow cross. But sometimes, when you have finished this sequence of moves, the cross is still in a not correct form, so you have to repeat this up to 8 times, if it's required. So in step number 5, the last step, we have to position these 4 corners. And in particular, we have to put the proper colors. So, for example, here we have a red-green, which is not right because we have red and blue, and here again orange, blue, and here we have red and green, and so on. So we have to position in the right way these four little cubes. And here we have again a sequence that we have to perform. So we have to do left rotation up on the right side, right rotation up in the left side, left rotation down in the right side, right rotation down in the left side. Then we have to check if something is changed, but as we can see, we have only this cube which is correct, because you see blue and orange, and so it's correct. Instead, the green and red is not correct, and so on. So we can keep this on the right upper corner and perform again the same sequence of movements. So rotation left, up, right, up, left, down, right, down. And here we have orange, blue, which is correct. Here we have red and green, which is not correct, and so on. So we repeat again, left, up, right, up, left, down, right, down. Now we have blue and red, blue and orange, and these are correct. Then we have green, red, and green, orange. So the colors now are correct, but the orientation of these faces, of these cubes, is not correct. We have to put the yellow here, and of course the other colors on the other two sides. So this is the second phase of the fifth step, and we have again a sequence which is always the same, and we have to repeat. So we have to for example, if we have a situation where here we have yellow, or here, for example, these two are yellow and not here, so they are correctly they have the correct orientation, then we don't consider these two, and we start from this one, which is the first wrong cube, and then we proceed with the second. In this case, we have four wrong corners, so we start where we prefer. And the sequence is this. So it's down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right. And now we see that this corner is perfect. So we have to turn 90 degrees on the left side, and then we have to repeat down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right. And now we see that also this is correct, green and red. So we turn again on the left, and we consider this one, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right. And this time we see the red, blue is in the correct position. Then we rotate again 90 degrees, and this is the last one, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right, down, left, up, right, and down, left, up. And we finished. Unbelievable, but true. Following all the sequences in the right way, correctly, you obtain the cube as expected.